2 at 10. Residents from around Jackson converged on the scene of a deadly hit and run tonight to pray. Daryl Deadman, a white teen, is accused of murder for the deadly hit and run that claimed the life of James Craig Anderson, a black man. Now, this case hit a fever pitch earlier this week with the release of this surveillance video. It allegedly shows Deadman and John Aaron Rice beating Anderson and then Deadman hitting and killing him with his truck. The district attorney in Hinds County calls it a hate crime. Some residents say it's a reason to pray. 16 WAPT's Aaron Kelly joins us now live in Jackson with more on that. Aaron.
Scott, hundreds walked from the New Horizon Church up the street to lay a wreath and light candles here outside the Metro Inn on Ellis Avenue. It was back in June that Anderson died just steps away from here. But organizers say it wasn't until they saw surveillance video of what the DA is calling a hate crime that they decided to gather together in prayer. Walking steps from where James Craig Anderson was killed in an alleged hate crime, hundreds from the Jackson area came to say, not in our city.
I was outraged and horrified and sickened that somebody would do that.
Sue McClain came from Madison.
It's wrong for people to take justice into their own hands like this young man did, and now justice needs to deal with him.
She joined others from Hinds, Madison, and Rankin counties to lay a wreath outside the Metro Inn on Ellis Avenue, near the scene of the crime. The hit-and-run death gained national attention last week after this surveillance video was released. The district attorney says it shows 18-year-old Daryl Deadman running over James Craig Anderson with his truck.
We didn't know the intensity of the crime, and it wasn't until, of course, the release of the video that we really understood the depthness of it.
A lawyer for Anderson's family says they appreciate the support that's come following the release of that video.
They want the attention, but they want justice for James Craig Anderson. And so if the attention helps bring justice for James Craig Anderson and it helps bring light to this problem, they're all for it.
Now, lawyers for the victim's family have created the James Craig Anderson Foundation for Racial Tolerance. They say funds from that foundation will be used to sponsor community meetings on racial tolerance. Now, 18-year-old Daryl Deadman remains at the Hinds County Detention Center tonight on $800,000 bond. Live in Jackson, Aaron Kelly, 16 WAPT News.
Thanks a lot, Aaron. Appreciate it. 18-